Wheel of time, keep on rolling, 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 what? Rolling, 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 come on. All right, friends, it's your man Z, and I'm here from Our Reviews Will Kill You to talk a little bit about Amazon's The Wheel of Time. Now, I'm not going to pretend that I know Jack Squadoncle about The Wheel of Time. I don't know anything about it, so don't ask. I'm not an expert. I have not read them like I read all of the Game of Thrones books, but I did get it from a very good source, an anonymous source of mine, who is the hugest of Robert Jordan fans, that that these books are absolutely phenomenal, if not one of the best books he's ever read. And he was a man who told me back in the 90s that Game of Thrones was going to be the biggest thing anyone's ever seen. So a good like 10 years before it ever even like people even started talking about it, this man knew. So I'm going to take it on good authority that this is a good thing too. Now, what we don't know, I think it's like 14 books, so this thing could go on forever. And the good part is all the books are done. So the source material is there. It's just for them to adapt, and they just have to do a good job with it. So the interesting thing is that the critic scores have dropped. And normally here at Our Reviews Will Kill You, we don't care about the critic scores. But it seems like there's been a recent shift, and we don't know what it is, but it seems like critics have kind of started to just do their job. I don't know. It seems to have started with the Eternals. Something has shifted. There was also a lot of criticism of Disney Plus Day, so I don't know what's going on, but we're going to take a look just to give a little sneaky taste and see what this all looks like. Thank you to Bounding Into Comics to have this little thing here. And you'll see that our reporting's a little bit different from Bounding Into Comics because we're going on a little bit later from them. But the Metacritic score and Rotten Tomatoes have just updated. Currently has a score of 74% fresh, which is not great. But, you know, this is high fantasy. So people are, you know, critics. This isn't made for critics. So I don't know that they're going to like it. But some people have been saying things like, despite weak characterization, they still found it rather watchable. I saw someone else somewhere say something like, it's cosplaying to Game of Thrones, but I don't think it's supposed to be Game of Thrones. You know, it's a different writer, different material. They say the material is there and the execution so far seems up to the task. And you gotta remember, this is just the beginning. So maybe it gets better. I remember when Game of Thrones first started, it wasn't like the greatest thing since sliced bread. It was like, okay, this is kind of cool. I got to get into this. So it's going to take time for us to understand all the different characters and all the different things. This person from The Verge says that The Wheel of Time, when it does fire on all cylinders, is proof that it might actually be possible to fit the book into a coherent TV show. Okay. That sounds like a thing. It's starring Rosamund Pike as some crazy name, Damodred? I do not know. This guy says it's both better and worse than the books, and yet for some reason I'm ready for more. All right then. Somebody else here at the Metro says, as far as fantasy series go, The Wheel of Time delivers and then some. And this is most of it's only based that they were only given 6 episodes. So you got to give them time. You know, the weird thing about Amazon is that they sometimes just cancel things and or forget about them. Like they clearly spent a lot of money on this. So maybe by the end of 6 episodes, it gets better. You know, people were struggling to get through The Witcher and then things kind of came together and got all coherent. So people were excited about that. This person says they gave it a rotten rating, but they said based on the 6 episodes available for review, The Wheel of Time doesn't seem inherently unfilmable. It simply could have been filmed better. Okay, keep going. This person says, will The Wheel of Time be a hit? Don't ask me. All I know is when I went into a kind of death spiral after watching the first episode. So, and that's where it's tough. Like, what are you going to do? Some people are going to love it. Some people are going to hate it, I'm sure, because people just don't like fantasy. And, you know, as a reviewer myself, sometimes you're forced to watch things that just aren't in your wheelhouse, right? And I don't really think, you know what I mean? Like, it's hard to say. Like, you got to watch some things and you're just like, God, I don't even want to watch this. So we'll take a look at it. I have somebody who is going to binge as much of it as possible and give me a full report. That same anonymous source. We'll take a look and see what they say. There's not a lot. It's got a 61. That's not a lot of reviews for Metacritic. 61 seems a little low. I don't know. At least it's not getting review bombed either from the critics, or like doesn't seem like there's a lot going on. So Metacritic still has it at 61. And we'll see. Like I said, I don't hear a lot of hype about this, but I've heard a lot of hype in the sense that this is a really good set of books that people are really excited about. It's got a really loyal fan base. So we could see something really great, or we could see, you know, maybe it flops spectacularly. I just don't know. Rolling Stone didn't like it, so maybe that's a positive, because you can't trust Rolling Stone. They say at Rolling Stone, Wheel of Time is arriving in this long gap between the end of Game of Thrones and the premiere of several other shows like it, which may bring in some fantasy starved for any morsel of magic and wonder, but the whole thing is empty if expensive calories. Okay. It'll be interesting too, because you've got the Lord of the Rings coming out on Amazon too, and does this give you any hope for the Amazon Lord of the Rings? Tell me in the chat, because I don't know. If you're a Robert Jordan fan, tell me what you think. Are you excited for this? Are you not excited? I don't know either. I'm just going off of my sources who say they're super stoked for this and that this could be like something game-changing, or just a really exciting TV show. Your call. Anyway, let us know what you think. Subscribe, please. Hopefully I earned your subscription today, and you can get more of us from Our Reviews Will Kill You here. We also have a great podcast that is free for you to listen to on Spotify, Stitcher, and iTunes, any of those fun places. And catch us anytime you can, because we also live stream on Friday nights, 7:30 p.m. Come join the fun. Some giveaways and some other good stuff. So from all of us here at Our Reviews Will Kill You, to all of y'all at home, we love y'all. And I'm out. Till the next one.